I think what this whole concern having to do with native speakers shows us is that we're getting very sensitive to artificial boundaries and artificial lines that are being drawn only based on external factors. I think what we're all craving for is for the world to allow us to feel valued for our skills and for the hard work that we put into acquiring of our skills by validating the effort that we take to raise our skills, but not the objective and external factors that we had little to no responsibility for. And I feel like this native speakers bias is very hurtful to many people just for that reason, just for that very reason. We feel like this whole native speakers bias highlights a certain level of futility in terms of our effort. It makes us feel very incapable. It's as if no matter what we do, no matter how hard we try, there will always be someone who will exceed us, who will be superior to us just based on their place of origin or something like that. And that is very, very offensive and very unfair and unjust to many of us. And it is obviously indicative of black and white thinking that many people have, although the world really lacks criteria which would be more, let's say, humane and fair, instead of certificates and diplomas and paper documents that actually are considered as papers that back up a person's understanding of a certain matter. We really need other criteria. We really need a different kind of context where people's contribution would be assessed and valued based on its level of consciousness, for instance, of its level of goodness, of its quality. And for that, we really need a different definition of quality. I really think that we need to rethink how we impose value or how we grant value to different humans, to different forms of being in our world. The current way of assigning value is very much objective credentials based. And that is only a situation due to the fact that we don't have other criteria in place. If we had different criteria in place, we would probably stick by those criteria, but we don't. So perhaps the focus for our attention as teachers would have to be on creating different criteria based on which we can assess a person's ability to teach well, to contribute to the teaching profession or whatever profession it is. How do we do that? What other criteria can we bring to the table? Can we bring to the table the criteria of a person's subjective empowerment? How empowered and confident do they feel after receiving guidance from that particular teacher? How happy do they become after having worked with that teacher for a period of time, for instance? It's really interesting that what is happening in the world has to do with the value that we assign to objective experience, to third-person phenomena, as opposed to first-person phenomena. We don't pay enough respect to first-person phenomena, and very often in a scientific community, we dismiss it as not as valuable as third-person phenomena, third-person observation. So that contributes to a need for third-person credentials, and we assign value to someone's contribution based on our assessment of their credentials, on how much time they have spent in a scientific community, as if that matters. And sometimes that does contribute to their ability to manage a situation effectively, but very often it doesn't. For instance, we don't have a criteria for self-study. We don't consider self-study as valuable when a person is trying for a vacancy, for instance, as an objective credential or a paper signed by a mentor from a university or someone who is giving them a reference from their previous job. And that is something that I would really love to change in the world. I think this is something that we as teachers need to step forward.